My melanoma story, without a doubt, is the luckiest day of my life. We're in holidays in Bali. Now it sounds melodramatic, but it's true. At the time, I thought I was bulletproof. I didn't need to get a skin checked. I'm a tough Aussie bloke. I put a bit of factor four on when I was a kid, and I should be okay. So by the time I was 30-odd, I was in Bali on holidays with my wife, putting some cream on, and my wife noticed a small dot on the back of my leg just underneath my bum cheek. And my wife said, "What's that spot? I don't like the look of it." Typical me, Aussie bloke, "Don't worry about it, babe. It's always been like that." That ignorance could have cost me my life. From the beach in Bali, my wife made a phone call back home to the skin cancer specialist. We came home, lay down on the table, and the doctor took one look at me and said, "Mate, I don't like the look of that." I thought I was bulletproof. I didn't have to get a skin check. I've got dark skin anyway, I'm fine. Only fair-skinned people get melanomas. I should be sweet. They took the melanoma out with a 15-centimetre cut. I thought it was crazy. I thought, it's just a little mole. I've never seen a change in it. After 2 weeks, the pathology came back and it was a melanoma. It was 0.6 of a millimetre into my skin. Now at 1 millimetre, we all know you're in all sorts of trouble. After my melanoma diagnosis, I called an intervention. I got all my best mates over to my house for a barbecue. I said, "Boys, we all live a similar lifestyle. I've just been diagnosed with a melanoma. If it wasn't for the early diagnosis and treatment that I received, I could well not be here by Christmas. I want all of you to go and get a skin check." Now, they thought I was mucking around. The boys thought I was taking the piss. I couldn't be more serious. Out of the 15 boys that were at my house that day, 2 had full-blown melanomas. If it wasn't for that intervention and that feeling that I had in my gut to go beyond, beyond just trying to help and actually making a difference, those 2 guys could well have, not be here now, I guess. My mother, who's also been diagnosed with a melanoma, enrolled our family to do a genetic study at the university here in Sydney. I want the best possible prevention, the latest and greatest research, and heaven forbid, if and when someone close to me is diagnosed with cancer, the best available treatment. It's so scary that melanoma is the most prevalent cancer for 15 to 39 year olds. That's why I'm so proud to be an ambassador for the Melanoma Institute Australia, and in particular, Melanoma March. Get out and support Melanoma March, have a great day out, but more importantly, help us raise those funds to make a difference to melanoma.